Hey guys, Cypherunt here. Today I'm going to be going over some of the customs that I've been working on. I'll be telling you about some of the really fast ones and some of the ones that did alright. I'm not going to go over the slow ones because there are a few of those. But we're focusing on speed here. Besides, I'm going to be working on those a bit more. Make sure they're faster. So, we already went over this guy in a previous video. I showed you how fast it was to beat my friend Erning Fairmont. This is the AMC Javelin. Same wheels, I just added weight inside of it. Now, I didn't have anything to use for the weight, so I just put clay in there. it helped. It's quite a bit faster now. I mean, did alright. It did alright. So, anyways. Next we have this guy. No, I believe this is one of those cars that was sold at McDonald's a long time ago originally. I added a little bit of lead inside of it because I recently got lead, so I could use that inside of the vehicles. I'm hoping to get tungsten putty soon so I can make them even faster. But yeah, we have Matchbox wheels in the front and some normal wheels in the Matchbox wheels in the back and some normal wheels in the front. Pretty heavy. It's definitely fast. I had to take out the light because this thing could light up before. I had to take it out in order to make space for speed. And we got these two. Ford Expedition, full of clay. It's quite a bit faster than the Chevy Tahoe. And we got the penny truck number one. And the penny truck number two. Not really much to explain with these guys. Just, you know, put clay in the windows and whatever. And we have this guy. It's a pretty good custom. It's a NASCAR, you know, racing champs. I gave it new wheels. The super fast matchbox wheels, and I added lead to the inside of it. It doesn't even have to be glued, it's just you can hear it. But, you know, the lead doesn't have to be glued to any part of the car inside, it can rattle around and whatnot. That's what I found. But yeah, it rolls really well. It's pretty good. It's definitely not my fastest one. Alright, well. That being said, I'm going to show you some of the fast ones. First, you remember this guy from the last video? Powerhouse. Legendary racer goes on the shelf. Here's another one that I've been working on that is also a legendary racer. The Hades truck, or the Hades pickup. That's what I call it. Check this thing out. I'm putting the light so you can see. So, lead in the back. It's not one piece, but, you know. I might glue this at some point, I don't know. It's full of lead in the inside. I had to flush it out, take out the seats and the windows to be able to put this stuff in. Didn't really have to take out the windows, but I realized that too late. This thing is really, really fast. This thing weighs as much as the powerhouse. This guy right here, even though he's not nearly as big. Alright, next. We have the Sidewinder, number 66. Has the, not laser wheels, but the other kind of similar wheels from Matchbox I added to it. And it worked perfectly with this car. There's a few other versions of this that I customized, and they're not nearly as fast for some reason. This one just is. I think it's mostly because of the wheels. But as you can see, I call it the Sidewinder. because, check that out. Yeah, it rolls kind of weird. It's very heavy, full of lead. Pretty awesome stuff. And that one is more than likely faster than those two, believe it or not. Now there's one more vehicle that I will show. Now this one is not glued yet because I ran out of super glue. I'm gonna need to get more. Once I get more, I'll probably update you on this. For now, I'll actually show you how I made this. So, inside there's this vacant, large vacant space in there. I place a giant amount of lead in here. Then I put this right there. Then I quickly turn that around. And voila. And this, I raced it at one point. Too soon, and this is how I know it's a legendary racer, okay? I raced it at one point too soon, and because I thought the glue was dry, and this was the last of the glue that I had, and I got really excited and wanted to race it as soon as I possibly could, so I put it down the track, and it beat every single car that it came, that every single car that it was up against in that one race. By 4 car lengths. Now, that's more than fast enough to be on that shelf. But, I just want to say, yeah. So I also changed the wheels on this. Once I glue this, I'll definitely be able to do more races with that and probably will show a few. However, there is one more custom vehicle that I will be showing in an upcoming video. And boy is it fast. Boy is it cool. I even went out of my way to paint it. And I love the colors that I chose. So you will see that in the next video, most likely. Till then, Cypher GR. Peace.